is up, guys? Welcome back, dudes. We're here again on Andrew Penman YouTube unboxing and first ride. Today we've got a surfboard to unbox. I can see the skater dudes now just glazing over a thousand yard stare thinking, what the hell?
Let's get out of here, dude.
Yes, I'm a surfer of 43 years and a skateboard rider of 47, so you will see the odd unboxing of a surfboard. Today we're going to look at the foamies, the latest phenomenon coming in the surfing industry, soft foamies. They are taking the world by storm. This is the Jamie O'Brien model. We'll come back in a moment and have a look at the dimensions and the technicality and aspects of this board. So stick around and don't go away. Weighs about 3.5 kilos, super light. It's the Odysea, as you can see on the writing there. It's the log. There's a whole lot of range of boards in this particular company. You've got the Skipper, you've got the Odysea log, you've got the Stump. I picked this because of the weight factor. It can take my weight of 90 kilos. It's 57 liters of foam. That's extraordinary. 22 inches wide, 6 foot long, and 3.1 inches thick. As you can see, it's an awesome volume of foam here, and will certainly, as they say, the catchphrase is hog all the waves with the log. So this will be it'll pick up anything pretty much pretty quickly. Okay, the company coming out of California. This is Odysea. This is the company that Jamie O'Brien, big shout to Jamie O'Brien, check out his channel. Jamie downstairs, there's a link to your channel, doing some great work in Hawaii there. You want to check out some awesome footage of one of the best pro surfers in the world now, free surfers for Red Bull, check out Jamie's channel. He has some great stuff on there. This is the Jamie O'Brien signature model, not the actual design on the bottom, that's the classic Hawaiian sort of surf. Boys board short color back in the 1890s and the 1900s, they had the maroon and white. This pretty signifies that particular heritage of that particular design of board. Okay, so let's have a look at it. Basically, why are people getting into foam boards? Simple, because they are so buoyant. You can ride them in the flags. You can't get in trouble for sort of surfing amongst people. They're soft, they don't dent, they don't ding. They're easy to repair, they're great for traveling. They are so buoyant, you can catch anything on them. And they are really an enlarged, pretty much boogie board, but with a bit more high tech stuff. We've got triple stringers down here, through the center, moulded, which makes extra strength. You've got the FCS fin system in them, which will take the normal FCS fin, which I have plenty of, which works really well. And I'll talk about the fin systems in a minute. So there are numerous models, and we might go through. You've got the Beta, and you've also got the Skipper, you've got the Log, you've got the Stump, got the mini mouths. They're all there, and this is just an example of the range of boards you can get coming out of Odysea. They have got every possible thing you can imagine you'd want to have for these particular boards to ride at any conditions or any type rider. Well, let's unbox it and have a look at it. So we don't need a knife. With the world of surfboards, you just have to unpeel the vacuum seal foam and also the plastic that wraps it. Okay, so let's straight away take off the, there's a nice, these boards range around about $519 out here. That's the company logo. They are probably the premium Rolls-Royce range of, you know, obviously surfboards. These are the ones you you want to get yourself on. They are just incredible. There he is, Jamie. Fantastic stuff, love your work. That's the range of boards. I'll go through those in a second and talk about those. Indestructible, easy to travel with, incredibly buoyant, as I said, and just first class the way these things are made. They just are beautifully designed. I got this from Board Up in Munavale, Sydney here. They have a great range of Achilles Slater boards. They've got all the Mount Almerics, and they have an amazing range of these foamies. I can thoroughly recommend checking out the guys there, and talk to Saxon there. He's the guy that sold me this board. Okay, so straight away I can see this thing has the most incredible finish. Now, how this actually works is it's an extruded foam, so it's a poly styrofoam extruded cross-sectional closed cell type foam that has the core. We've got a triple stringer through here, which is actually molded to actually mold the shape of the board. As you can see, it's got a fair bit of rocker in that. You've then got the PE bottom HD, which is polypropylene. This is a lot harder than any sort of boogie board. It's still soft, it'll still dent, but it's a high quality finished bottom of it. FCS fins, as I've said, so you can put your fins in here. On that point, they do give you a fin setup here, which I'll have a look now. So we'll open this up, see what's in here. The beauty with this particular company is they do just have a standard FCS fins, as well as they will work with the FCS2s, as I understand. Okay, so yeah, like your skate tool guys, you have your fin tool for the surfboards. Okay, so I'll just get rid of that over there. Okay, so the fins they're giving you obviously are of just a clear white. You've got the classic surf catch symbol, the sort of palm tree on there. They'll fit in nicely, so they'll look like that, as you can see. What I am going to do, now with the fins, guys, you obviously, if you haven't surfed before, you've got the splayed edge fins that go on the outside, and you've got a completely rounded both sides fin that goes on the center fin at the back. I picked a thruster design. I absolutely love thrusters. I grew up in the sort of single fin era, and I got my first thruster probably 1980, 81 or 80. I remember seeing a guy surf up at Nirvana on it, and Central Coast, and I was just blown away with the speed these thrusters get. I'm not a big fan of the full fin or the twin fin. I have bought a Mark Richards twin fin, which I will show you later, an unbox of that. What I have got though is the standard Sunny Garcia fins. These are carbon fiber, and we will put those in, have a look at those now.
The stainless steel screws
that hold these in go in just beautiful in the tape. Any fin box and any FCS on any board I've had before. We're going to put the carbon fibers in right now, see how they look. Let me point out, guys, that if you are using the fiberglass fins, you probably won't be able to use them in the surf, because there is an issue regarding fiberglass fins in the surf with swimmers. So, you know, even though it's a foam board, if you're using fiberglass fins, there could be an issue regarding concerns of riding in the flags. Even the boards, the fins they give you are pretty much fiberglass. So yeah, either way, there you go. You have the Sunny Garcia fins on that. They're pretty impressive. This is going to really drive through the water beautifully. These fins have got a great flex on these carbon fibers, as you can see, and these will work beautifully. However, I'm not going to use those. What I'm going to use is a different fin system, and that is the H2s. What these are like a steel mesh, fiberglass kind of carbon fiber. And what these are a FCS H2 fin. Yes, those of you who are watching are saying, yeah, we've seen these before. 18 years ago, a guy designed the fin whereby normally a fin system, it sits in with the base being quite straight. So when it sits in like that, it's got the exact angle of that fin. What the H2 fins did was have a bend on the bottom. So instead of sitting like that, they would sit more like that, splay out. So effectively splay out. So if I put that normal fin system in the Sunny Garcia carbon fiber, it's pretty much lined up with the nose. It's got a slight, you know, slight angle on it, slight splay. But when you put the H2 fin in, you can watch the difference quickly. It sits right out. It sits way out. Now I'm gonna put these on my board on this, because you can see that those splay right out on those fins. I think with a foam board and having this splay right out, which means I think with this kind of volume, this kind of width, 22 inches, it's gonna help just power those turns even better. So they look really good. The yellow boxes with the silver H2 fins on the large size. I've also got the Sunny Garcia ones. This is gonna be an awesome board to perform on beach break, small surf, and even down the line point surf a little bit. We'll get rid of that sticker there. Right, so look, we're gonna now just talk a little bit about the actual specs of this board, and I'll talk about it right now. It's really gonna float me out of the water pretty much. It's gonna be an amazing feel to catch waves. The finish on this is a really nice, this is a polypropylene finish on the top, a polyethylene in the inside waterproofing system. And they really are quite solid, and you can't really dent them or hit them too hard and punish them. If you do, you go to Whitworth's Boating and get a rubberized glue. It just squeezes on and dries hard, the bit of flexibility like silicon, and you're good to go again. So guys, we're gonna get out in the surf and have a look at it, and I'll take some shots of it now so you can see it. These are $519 to $550 in Sydney, depending on where you're getting them from. I can thoroughly recommend this company. They look after you. They've got a great reputation. Coming out of California, Odysea are doing some amazing stuff with foam boards, and I can really recommend this is one of the premier foam boards to get. And you'll really be impressed with the drive this thing gets off the top and off the bottom. So that's it, guys. That's the Odysea. And I think at the end of the day, when you want to get waves that are small and it's summer surf, this is the exact board that you need to do that sort of performance with. And whacking these fins in will be a fantastic effect on what I'll be looking for in the water, which is performance surfing. Let's go down the beach, have a look at it. We'll get some shots of it now in HD, and I'll give you the full links below to where you get them from. As I said, this is probably one of the most revolutionary changes in surfboard design the last 10 years in terms of using these foamies for everything. Jamie O'Brien surfs Pipeline off the wall. He surfs the Maldives. He surfs pretty much Neos. You're looking at some of the most suckiest waves in the world, and this board will handle everything. So thanks guys for coming on board today and having a look at the Odysea range of boards, including this one, the 6 foot log, which is 22 inches wide, 3 inches thick, 57 liters of foam, would suit someone say 90 kilos and greater, and this is gonna be such a fun board to ride with the classic Hawaiian retro stripes on it. We'll go out now, have some photos of it, have a first ride and see how it goes. I'll give you my feedback on how it performs. Thanks so much, we'll be back in a moment. Okay, we're just gonna put these fin boxes in now, just tighten them and then pull back half a turn so they're nice and solid. A bit of flex on that, which is nice. And the front one here, just make sure when you line them up that that little hole there, it just lines up exactly with. Conversion, hope and pray it might come true. The wax up. I've just waxed it. I've used the hot water balling method in a plastic container to get a really nice wax on this. It looks pretty good. They do get a bit clumpy and they start falling off because it's a soft deck, as you can see. So yeah, they do tend to come off after a while, but you get most of it on like that. Then you put the leg rope on, make sure you do a reef knot behind there, make sure the rail saver meets the whole way around. I've got this nice Almeric one, which is pretty, geez, they're skinny now, they're tiny, look at that, like a boogie board type one. But that's all you need, I suppose. New technology, hexagonal strength cord. So that's pretty much it, guys. Ready to go for a surf, dudes. Unfortunately, no one to watch me or film me, so I'll have to go out for a surf and come back and give you a feedback on this, but I will get some footage of me out on it at some point. That's the unbox, guys, and set up. Let's get to the surf and see what's happening down here. Some good swell today. I think some nor'east trade winds blowing. Hopefully we'll get some nice waves. These fin systems are really good. I'm loving that. Okay, well, let's go for surf.
Okay, guys, we're taking the Jamie O'Brien out today for a surf. We're testing it out, seeing how it performs. I haven't got anyone to sort of video me, unfortunately. I've got some random dude to video me now, but there we have it. All waxed up, ready to go. This is a Jamie O'Brien model. So let's go for a surf, check it out, and see what this thing can do.
Yeah, guys, at Manly today. That's the Jamie O'Brien I'm taking out. Some decent waves out here. Looks a bit of fun.
So we're gonna test it out and see how it performs, how it paddles, if it's worthy of the price, as you can see. And we'll just check it out today. There'll be no one to film me, but I will have some video of me surfing in the next video. Let's get out there.
Not bad little surf out there today. It's a bit of an onshore bowl out, but just giving it a hose off. Always hose the fresh water off over your boards. Never leave the salt on them. You've got to get the water, salt water off. Okay, so today, what I found was, number one, the feeling on the chest. It's soft when you ride. It's like laying on a doona cover. It's just smooth on your chest. You don't get that bruising ribs or sternum. I get those calcifications on the chest after a while from the bones being rubbed, and you get that fat tissue build up to protect the bones. You don't get that because this board's super soft. It's just absolutely a pleasure to lay on. It calves, it takes waves really quickly, being 58 litres. One hell of a rush, it just takes anything. It's got a beautiful capacity to turn, it's got a lot of carving. Yeah, it's one of the best boards I've ridden in a long time. So if you're an advanced surfer like me, or you're beginning or learning, this is the Odysea Jamie O'Brien model. The CatchSurf log. It's an amazing board and I can thoroughly recommend it. We'll get some footage of me surfing coming down the track, but for now, this is the sign off on the unbox and first ride of the Odysea log. 6 foot, get yourself one, dudes. It's incredible. It'll change your life. And it's like riding a whole new board. The soft top design is unbelievably soft, and the bottom is so smooth and fast. It picks up anything. You can virtually ride anything that hardly even moves. So yeah, Andrew Penman signing off today on the first ride unbox on the Odysea log. 6 foot, 58 litres. Thoroughly recommend it. Get into it, guys, and see you in the next video.